Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study, continue the lesson, real numbers. So last time we had seen the rational numbers are of two types, recurring type and non-recurring type. We have learned how to convert them into decimal form and how to recognize the recurring and non-recurring without calculating. Now today we are going to express recurring decimals in p upon q. Okay, last time you all had done p upon q form to recurring. Now this year you all are going to do express recurring decimals in p upon q form. So let us take practice set 2, point 1. Practice set 2.1, sum number 3. Write the following rational numbers in p upon q form. 0.6 recurring. So let us follow step by step. First, we have to say let x equal to 0.6 recurring. Now, see how many numbers are recurring here. How many numbers are recurring? Only one. Whenever one number is recurring, you have to multiply by 10 because 10 has got 10. Okay. So first we'll x is equal to 0.6 recurring means what? 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. So one number is recurring, so multiply 10 both sides. So when you multiply 10 both sides, here it will become 10x, and over here the decimal point will shift one place to the right, so it will become 6.6666. So this 6 is recurring, 6.6 recurring, multiplying by 10 both sides. Okay, now what you have to do next step is subtracting 1 from 4. Which is 1? This is 1. 1 from 4. So 10x minus x is equal to, subtract the right hand sides also, 6.6 recurring minus 0.6 recurring. So the answer is 6.0. So here we have done the subtractions. 6.6 recurring minus 0.6 recurring, you are getting 6.0. Okay, so further 10x minus x is what? 9x. And this is 6. 9x is equal to 6. So x is equal to 6 upon 9. On reducing, you're getting 2 upon 3. Okay, so that was it. So now we go to the next one. So you should follow the steps of the, just understand the steps. You copy it into your notebook and do it 2-3 times so you will understand the steps. The same steps are followed in the next sum. So the second sum is 0.37 recurring. How many numbers are recurring here? Two numbers, 3 and 7, 37. So the same step, first what we do, let x equal to 0.37 recurring. So then let us write the recurring numbers. X is equal to 0.3737, etc. It goes on and on. Now how many numbers are recurring? How many numbers are there recurring? Two numbers. When two numbers are recurring, you have to multiply by 100 because 100 has got two zeros. In the first sum, it was one number recurring, so you multiplied by 10. Now here, we can see two numbers recurring. So two numbers recurring means multiply by 100 because 100 has got two zeros. Here, two zeros. So when you multiply this number by 100, the point will shift two place to the right. So you get 37.37. So that is recurring. 37.37 recurring. So 100x is equal to 37.37 recurring. Now the next step is 100x minus, take subtracting 1 from 4. So this is 1. From 4, you have to subtract. So 100x minus ax is equal to, subtract the right hand side also, 37.37 recurring minus 0.37 recurring. So now here we get 99x is equal to 37. X is 37 upon 99. See, here I have shown the subtraction. This recurring 37 minus 37 gives you 0 because same numbers are minus. And 7 minus 0, 7. 3 minus 0, 3. That's how you get 37. So the final answer is 0.37 recurring is 37/99. Now let us go to the next sum. Third sum is for homework. Now I'm going to do the fourth sum. Here again 15.89 recurring. How many numbers are recurring? Two. So that means two numbers are recurring means you have to multiply by 100. 100 has got two zeros, no? Okay, let us follow the steps. First step is let x is equal to 15.89 recurring. So now what does 15.89 recurring means? X is equal to 15.898989. So you have to multiply by 100x. 100 both sides you multiply. 100 when you multiply in the left hand side you get 100x. And 15.89 into 100, the decimal point shifts two places to the right. 100 into 15.8989. This I have shown the recurring form here. It shifts two places to the right. So you get 1589.8989. So 100x is equal to, now this 8989 which is recurring as shown by a bar on top. Now subtract 1. Same steps are followed, 1 from 4. 100x minus x is equal to 1589.89 recurring minus 15.89 recurring. So here I am going to do the subtraction in this corner. 1589.89 recurring minus 15.89 recurring. So now here what do you get? 89 minus 89 is 0 and 1589 minus 115 is 1574. So you get 100x minus 1x is 99x is equal to 1574. So x is equal to 1574 upon 99. So the final answer is 15.89 recurring is equal to 1574 upon 99. Now the next sum, fifth sum, 2.514 recurring. First step, let x is equal to 2.514 recurring. Second, recurring means, what does recurring mean? Let x is equal to 2.514514 recurring. Now here, can you see there are three numbers recurring. So you have to multiply by 1000 because 1000 has got three zeros. So multiply 1000 here and then multiply 1000 here. When you multiply 1000 here, it goes three places to the right. So 2514.514514. That you can write it as 1000x is equal to 2514.514 recurring. Now 1000x minus x is equal to 2514.514 recurring minus 2.514 recurring. So let us do the working column, find out 2514.1514 minus 2.514. How much is it? 2.0. So next, 1000x minus 1x is 999x is equal to 251. So x is equal to 2512 upon 99. So the final answer 2.514 is equal to 2512/99. Okay, now we have completed with the practice set 2.1. One sum is for homework, the third sum. Now we same type of sum is there in problem set 2. So I'm taking those sum, the similar one. Page 35. Question number 2.4. The same sum. You have to convert it into P upon Q form. So I'm doing all that type from the problem set. So what is our step? First step, how many numbers are recurring here? Can you see 417? So that means three numbers are recurring. So you have to multiply by 1000. 1000 is what? 30. Let x is equal to 357.417 recurring. I have put a bar here to show that it is recurring. So x is equal to 357.417417. You have to multiply by 1000 both sides. 1000x is equal to, when you multiply this by 1000, the point shifts three places to the right. So you get 357.477 from 417. 1000x is equal to this. 35417.417 recurring. Now, what is our method now? Subtract this 1 from 3. So, 1000x minus x is equal to, subtract the right hand side now, 3577.417 recurring minus 357.417 recurring. So, you get 99x, and when you subtract this, here I have not shown the subtraction, when you subtract it, you will get 357060. So, x is equal to 357060 upon 99. So, our final answer is 35.7417417 recurring is equal to 357060 upon 999. Okay, now problem set 2. I am going to do one more sum. The fifth one. Fourth and fifth I am doing 1, 2, 3 is for homework. Same way 30.219 recurring. So, let x is equal to 30.219 recurring. How many numbers are here repeated? 3. So multiply by? Correct. 1000. So x is equal to 30.219219. Multiply by 1000 both sides. You get 1000x is equal to 30219.219. When you multiply by 1000, 3 place to the right, it shifts. So you get 30219.219 recurring. Now what is the next step? Subtraction. Correct. Subtract 1 from 4. 1000x minus x is equal to 30211219 recurring minus 30.219 recurring. So you get 1000x minus 1x is 999x is equal to, when you subtract this, you get 30219 minus 219, which is equal to 30189. So x is equal to 30189 upon 999. So final answer, 30.219 recurring is equal to 30,189 upon 999. Okay, now here is the homework for you. First of all, you have to copy each and every sum done in this video into your notebook. And then further homework is practice at 2.1, sum number 3 was left. So that you have to do the same steps, and problems at 2, page 35. Sum number 2, 1, 2, 3. Children, these are steps. So if you cannot understand, you have to do that each sum you take and write it down 5 times. Then you will understand the steps, and then all other sums follow the same steps. Okay. Thank you.